Is Science U, the Forensic Science Next Generation Camp, and the purpose of our camp is to have our campers go through and process a full crime scene, and then to take the evidence back to the lab and analyze it, and hopefully figure out who's committed the murder that we've got planned for them.
Now we are about to search the crime scene and try to find out who killed the Dr. Sky.
So yeah, we've got this whole crime scene set up in the house. Each different team is working on this room. First off, my team is working on the living room. So as you can see, we've got, you know, kind of different pieces of evidence and things everywhere. And each camper basically has a different role. So for example, there's a photographer, there's someone who's logging all the photographs, someone's taking down case notes, and someone's in charge of measurements and sketch. So in that case, everyone has a different role, they're all working together, and then each different room, they're gonna switch roles, so everyone gets a taste of everything they can do here.
So our friend here, she's taking the pictures of the scene, which first are the establishing, which is just showing us where everything is. And then next, she would have to take middle and then close-ups of the evidence, which is the blood pool, the blood trail, and then the wall.
So what are you writing down there?
So I need to write the numbers of photos she took and what they were about.
I'm doing measurements, so that's basically whatever, I guess, DNA you find or anything on the floor, that's evidence. You're gonna measure like the distance between that and like the couch or that and the wall. And then you'll measure like all the walls, so that way you know exactly like the shape of the wall and stuff. That way the next time, because people won't know exactly when they leave the crime scene, so that way you have all the dimensions and stuff when you leave the crime scene, so it's easier to, like, I guess, reenact what happened in the crime.
I'm really challenging them this week. This is not an easy crime scene. They're really gonna have to think critically. They're really gonna have to go through their evidence and really think about it. We're not handing them any answers. One of the things I always say about forensic science is that it's like putting together a puzzle, but you have to make the pieces. So these campers are gonna have to make the pieces out of their evidence, then they're gonna have to put them together themselves, and then they're gonna have to tell us what it all means. And at the end of the week, we're gonna play a video, and hopefully what they think happened in the crime scene matches what the actual scenario was, or that it's pretty close, but it'll be really fun to see if they can figure out who actually committed the crime based off of their evidence work this week.
We're testing the evidence to find out what it is. So we're using different reagents, and we're right now I'm crushing up pills, and we're gonna put the reagent into it, and it'll turn a different color if it's a certain evidence.
So what the kids are doing with the drug samples that they collected from the crime scene is they're doing a basic color test. And this is a presumptive test just to tell you whether or not you actually have a drug. And then you can also tell you a basic class of drug, and that will guide the later testing that you do. This is just a presumptive test. It's kind of send you in the right direction. And then later on, they're going to do GCMS, which is a separation technique that vaporizes your sample and then separates the individual components based on their boiling points. So we're gonna go and use the GCMS instrument later.
We're extracting the DNA from the strawberries.
Yeah.
is to basically get an understanding of how to extract DNA so that when we do it tomorrow with our samples, we'll know what to do. So basically, this is strawberry mash, and it's the lysed strawberries, so basically it's all broken up, and we're going to be adding mixtures to it so we can extract the DNA.
Okay, so what we just did was we are looking at our fingerprints we gathered from the crime scene. We enlarged the photo so we could see like the different areas. First we figured out where we wanted to circle to see what we could analyze. So we're going to take this picture and compare it next to other fingerprints. So we circled different areas, such as over here we saw like where the bifunctionals were, and right over here we can see where the ridge endings are. So that can help you determine whose fingerprints it came from.
Just because one of the things I love about forensic science is that forensic science uses all of the sciences. We're an applied science. So we take chemistry and physics and math and biology and biochemistry and any of the other sciences you could think of, and we sort of mix them all together and use whatever science information we have to solve the crime. So I'm hoping that the campers that we have this week are going to take the evidence we have and the activities that we have and all of their experiments, and whatever kind of science they like, whatever kind of science they're into, they're going to be able to use some of that here in forensic science and hopefully be able to make a good connection to it, because I think forensic science is so much fun because you get to use everything, and I hope that the campers have a really fun time with it too.